Hello, my name is William Gladstone, and I'm going to narrate A Skeptic's Guide to Your Spiritual Credit Score, which was originally recorded with clairvoyant Marisa Moris and her guides. Today, her dad, Joe Moris, is going to be the voice of the guides. Marisa is actually in a trance when she transcribes the guides. My part is exactly as it was with the original transcription. So you're going to enjoy this book. This is the first of several. And we're going to start this book right now. And I'm sure you're going to enjoy it.
Okay. I'm Joe Moris, by the way. I'm Marissa's dad. I've co-author other books, mainly biblical books, with Marisa. And Marisa co-authors with Bill and Gail Gladstone on the Skeptic series. So we've just finished up, or I just finished up the recording of the audiobooks for the Bible Speak series. And Marisa would normally be here to read these transcripts that we have, or these manuscripts that we have. But as she explained to me, if she was reading her part in here, all of a sudden, all of her guides would be coming in and be chattering away in her ear, and she wouldn't be able to complete what's in the text. And the next thing you know, we'd have a bazillion tangents. So I'm going to fulfill Marissa's portions in this book, The Spiritual Credit Score from A Skeptic's Guide. And once again, William Gladstone, Marisa Moris are the authors, and we'll get started very briefly.
Chapter 1. Snow Globe. This is part one, how to calculate and understand your spiritual credit score. We actually had a session several weeks ago touching on this topic, but we want to go back now and provide the rudiments so that first-time listeners can understand how we arrive at a spiritual credit score and gain a basic overview of using what Marisa has called the snow globe to understand at a very preliminary, simple level what elements go into creating a spiritual credit score, and how the concept of the snow globe can be useful to the average person who has no background necessarily on spiritual layers or spiritual dimensions or energy or any of the elements that people who have been following these books already have. So let's just start with the basic concept of the snow globe.
Well, let us just start by saying Saint Germain is the primary guide here, and by explaining how the snow globe came about so that the readers can get an understanding and be able to relate to this concept. Please understand that this channel has not been channeling her entire life. She had a spiritual awakening in 2008. When beginning to channel and learning to channel, it is very hard and very complicated to discern what is and what is not for one's highest and best good. A channel must just have faith and belief in something greater than him or herself. There is not very much education on the planet at this time, and in realizing how tough it was for Marisa to know whether something was good or bad that was within her field, she began to ask questions. She began to ask us, the guides, for a way to understand and a way to see how the energy was moving through her field without actually being able to see, for she was not able to see energy.
Okay, my very first question is, metaphorically, the snow globe is a person's energy field. Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay. So the concept of the snow globe was presented to Marisa so that it would be easier to explain the concepts of a person's energy field. And that is the reason for the snow globe metaphor.
Yes. Very simplistically, yes. And it's even simpler than that. It's just what is in just one space at any given time.
Okay. I have an energy field. Let's use me. I'm Bill. So I have an energy field. So let's say I have, for this explanation, a snow globe. So what are the elements in my snow globe?
End of chapter one. Chapter two, your body is your statue. Marissa's guide. The elements of your snow globe is that the statue is your third dimensional body.
Your third dimensional body? Statue? What is a statue?
The statue is your third dimensional body.
Well, I'm just Bill. I don't know about my third dimensional body. As far as I know, I only have a third dimensional body. I'm on this earth. So can we just say my...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.